Right, y'all. We're back. From what I remember, I wanted to do side quests before continuing on. Yeah, we need to go back to Coral and finish some of the shit here that we left. Oh, we can't even go because it's a different region. We need a thing. But where the fuck is the thing? We don't even have a thing. We are going to an airship, so maybe that will take us there. Anyways, we could do the side quest in this area. Why not? Let's do them.
That should do it. For now, at least. Say, can you spare a minute?
Not really.
You know that weird black stuff coming out of the reactor? Well, the wind seems to be carrying it all the way over here. I'll admit my shack's never been in the best condition. But look at it. Holes everywhere. Holes so big that would you believe it? All my chickens flew the coop.
Your thing looks fine.
But beyond that, I'm at wit's end here, let me tell you. Flapping and running around like crazy. How's an old woman like me supposed to catch them all? I can't keep up with a flock of chickens.
So we just need to catch your chickens, right?
Oh, thank you, dearie. Right. They love the sound of this here clanger. Use it and they'll come out from wherever they're hiding and follow you right back to the coop.
My nose should serve us well here.
Right. Take it away.
Three of them are still in the village. We should start by searching the surrounding area.
Hey, chicken hunting, let's go.
The longer you leave these buttes out to dry, the better they taste.
There.
Got away.
Okay. But for you, fucking chicken.
To square one.
Motherfucker. Stupid ass fucking chicken.
have made to get here.
Are you fucking serious? Like, how much of a charge is does that thing have? These fucking people. These fucking people, man. Pete's a little sad, but we should cook him.
Goodness me! How far could she have gone?
Hippoly ran off toward the airfield. We must find her before the fiends do.
Notice the helm stopped. Wonder what changed.
Long way back to town. Careful now.
Are you fucking serious? Okay. I hate this. This is absolutely stupid. I haven't, like, who thought of this? Yuffie, fucking move. Okay, I'm glad. I'm glad Square Enix did not just go absolutely fucking stupid and actually put that as a mission.
Some state-of-the-art Shinra weaponry into scrap metal.
Oh, so you heard about all that? Well, I don't want to brag or anything, but we crushed him.
Really? You have to teach me how you did that. Gotta make Zack proud, you know? He's a friend of mine. We grew up together, hung out and stuff. Haven't heard from him since he left the village, though. But I'm sure a soldier like him's pretty busy. We may not be at war, but I bet they've got him traveling all over.
Sorry, no can do. We're just passing through.
Please! I'm begging you!
Huh? Wait. Me?
I knew as soon as I saw your throwing star. From the moment I laid eyes on you and your weapon, I just had to make you my teacher. Please, Train me in your warrior ways.
Oh, I don't know. Well, since you're such a huge fan, one or two orbs might be enough compensation for my time. You sure you're up for the challenge?
Of course. I'll do anything.
Sweet music to my ears. Okay, new disciple. Meet me over there when you're ready. For pain.
Don't worry. I am more than ready to receive your wisdom.
Hey!
Come along. See what you can learn, my second disciple. First and foremost, a ninja must have stamina. So let's see how much you've already got, shall we? After all, a ninja warrior must be able to make a tactical retreat back to her comrades when they need her.
Understood, Master.
Very well. Then with that, let our training begin. I hope you're staying focused, my young disciple.
Teach me your ways, Master.
Need a breather.
Here goes. This one's for you. Don't catch a cold.
Sorry about that. This is someone looks kind of shaky.
Come on, no time to waste.
The saying goes, can't see the ninjas for the trees.
Deal with that.
I'm coming. Buckle up.
Farewell.
Go on. One more shot. Don't catch a cold.
Ready when you are. We're cold enough. I never miss. Take over.
I'll show you what I can do. Cut! Here it comes! Get him! Go on! It's your turn.
Take it
over, chili.
Them next time.
Now, strike swift and true!
Show me how it's done!
They're nothing.
Get him!
Take it from here.
catch a cold.
All right.
This might be it.
So long.
What the fuck? Bro, no, what?
Please, Master. Let me try again.
It says, bro, it literally says the fucking thing. Is ice, yeah, like blizzard.
Now strike swift and true.
Show me how it's done.
Like poison note and water or something.
Bundle up.
Just for that one. Okay.
I'm here.
That's it.
We made it?
I hope you've got more in you, because that ain't gonna cut it. Right, I'm gonna take a quick look around. You rest up for the next round.
I think you should focus on stamina, not strength.
Yeah, Zach told me the same thing. He used to train here all the time. Called it his secret gym. Of course, it wasn't much of a secret since everyone knew about it. But it sounded cool. Hard to live up to the legacy of a guy like that. Check this out. It was his favorite exercise. Her strength. Her body. And mind. Start. By training. You're behind.
Not like that. Gotta go deeper. Bend your knees more. Engage your glutes. And your quads.
Got it.
Bruh, lol.
Wherever he is, I hope he's doing good.
You cramping up? Get back.
Gotta be careful. Need a breather.
Come on, you can do it.
Get him!
I'll finish it.
Not looking good.
Why are we taking so much fucking damage all of a sudden, bro? Jesus, that is crazy. But like, we're gonna fucking escape that shit, like, are you serious?
It's not over yet. You'll forgive me.
Okay, Doug, yeah, okay, I got it. Okay, sure, whatever the fuck you wanna say, I don't, but I can't even, like, I don't know what to say to that. I can't even fucking escape the moves, yeah? They just haven't pinned down.
We made it?
I hope you've got more in you. That's it!
Let's go! Now! Do it!
Thank you. strong, okay? Together? Why don't you go?
I got this. With me! I got your number.
Time to turn the tide. And we're back. Nowhere to run. You ready?
We've got to get through this.
What? Why are they going to the air for? Fucking bitch. Used to fucking die.
Wow, all that training really paid off. Wait a sec, that's it. I've got an idea. See you back at the village.
Hello, what about my materia? in my face now, Tower.
What? How the fuck did we get up from here? This mission or whatever? What the fuck? Am I looking at like a zipline? No. I'm not fucking dealing with that stupid ass tower, bro.
So, we just talked it over. And we'd like to ask you to train all of us in the art of combat. Our coalition's only as good as its weakest member, so it only makes sense to get stronger together.
We're really just passing through.
But you could rest here for a while.
Our services don't come cheap. It'll cost you 1,000,000 gil.
That's a pretty steep price, but we could probably manage.
What?
Oh, and he forgot to mention materia. Preferably the precious kind.
That we can't do.
Look, Sotetsu, they may be good at their jobs, but don't you think they're asking a bit much? We're looking for training, not trouble.
If you're looking for someone to train you, then look no further. No money or materia required.
Well, thanks, Sisne. That'd be great.
But what about them? They're veterans of the battlefield, and under their tutelage.
What? My tutelage not good enough? In case you've forgotten, I've seen my fair share of action. If all of you are serious about upping your game, I'll help you out. In fact, I've been meaning to offer for a while now. Seeing as we're here, well...
Sounds good to me.
Me too.
Well, I thought it was a good idea. Sorry I wasn't able to convince the rest of them. It's just... I felt something when we first met. Almost like fate. And I guess I got a little carried away.
Don't sweat it.
Then that settles it. Listen up. There's no backing out now, so be warned. I won't go easy.
Roger!
Cloud, Yuffie! I know you've got to make a living and all, but you might want to consider lowering your rates.
I'll consider it after you consider paying me! Where's my materia? Three orbs, or two! Two's good!
Enough already. You're embarrassing yourself.
Just one, dude!
Most pleased to be reunited with you in this place they call home.
Thank you. They can be a handful, and chasing them really works up the appetite. So allow me to whip you up some of Grandma Kazra's famous grilled chicken. Say goodnight, Pippily.
Gotta eat.
No one's gonna live long, happy lives, bro. Nice. Good stuff, good stuff.
Thank you.
The whole kitchen smoking.
Watch your feet.
What the fuck?
What am I gonna do about you?
Wow, that's a smell.
We should go. Now.
Wait, don't leave. Treat you guys to a bowl if you help with the ingredients. The pumpkin put up a fight. The knife I've got wasn't long enough to chop it in one clean go. Had to get stabby. And that bulbous bastard. The onion. I mean, I had to close my eyes while I cut it. But that might have been a bad call. I feel ya. So, what more do you need? Morgan's vegetables. That dog's probably parked near the village entrance, selling his produce. You mind swinging by and picking up some of his stuff for me?
What a sweet boar you are, staying behind for me. You be good to Torgan now, you hear?
Did you just pay that dog money?
Oh, him? That's Melon, Torgan's pup. He comes by from time to time to sell their farm's produce. We grow our own veggies here in town too, but the ones from Torgan's field are especially delicious.
Come on, let's go after him.
My boy, how'd it go today? Good?
Hello.
Not seen you before. Out of towners?
Just visiting, yeah. So, could we buy some of your produce?
Can't help you. Don't sell to out of towners. Barely got enough for the locals as is. Judging by them duds you got on, you're city folk, ain't you? I ain't about to sell the bounty of my soil to young'uns who ain't never got down in the muck with me and mine. Now get.
I don't know the first thing about farming, but I do know how happy these veggies are. Can practically hear them.
Got an eye for the stuff. But you're telling me you got an ear, too? What's this one saying?
Something about how rich the soil is. How it can thrive and spread its roots deep, grow big and strong.
I'll be. Well, quit with the guilt tripping now, will ya? You know perfectly well I wasn't gonna leave them high and dry. We ain't seeing any more customers today, I reckon. So whatever we got left over is yours for the taking.
Thank you so much. We really appreciate it.
They finally learned to talk back?
Shh. We're actually trying to make Gungaga mushroom soup. What do you think we should use? Any advice would be great.
At the risk of stating the obvious, you'll need some quality Gungaga mushrooms. Or better yet, some Maganga mushrooms. They'll take that soup of yours to the next level. Things grow on a hill near here, but unless you got one hell of an eye, better to rely on a chocobo. They're flavorful suckers, so three calves ought to more than suffice. Pick them one at a time, though, if you want to keep your bird from getting all addled. Their aroma can be mighty powerful. And be mindful of the beasties, too. A lot of types are awful fond of the mushroom scent.
Gotcha.
Ah, and you can't forget the salt. Nothing brings out the flavor better than a sprinkling. And Maganga mushrooms being what they are, you're gonna want to savor it. Proper kind of salt for it's got a color close to this. Melon, you get them where they need to go.
Yay, I love defending dogs in this game. How do you go?
Do it! You're up.
Say no more.
Now. With me. Too bad.
Shaky. Looks like they're all slightly different colors. Let's see. Well, one of these ought to match Torkin's picture. What a gorgeous color. Almost feels like a waste to grind him up. I'd say that's the one we want. Yep. Nailed it. All right. I think we've got plenty of salt now. Next up are the Magunga mushrooms. Torkin said we'll need a chocobo to sniff them now.
String to the Shinra Resort's bow.
Damn it!
The rural getaway!
After all that time and
embrace
is it the design?
You'd be surprised how many people would go for it.
Not making any progress at all. To hell with it. Back to square one. Huh? Who are you? Whatever, I don't have time to... That arm... That magnificent arm! It is a weapon, but how does it work?
Oh wait, I came to the wrong... came to the wrong side quest, lol. Oh well.
Wait, have you been going around punching things with your attachments?
Occasionally.
Doing so ought to have given you multiple bone fractures. But this unique cylinder provides unparalleled shock absorption, allowing for high-impact performance. Who was the genius that built this?
An old friend, I guess. Don't know where he's at now, though.
Wait right there! Eureka! Sorry, got carried away. My name's Izo. I've been trying to create the ultimate weapon, but my attempts have all failed miserably. But thanks to you, I finally made a breakthrough. I must harness the inspiration while I can. Please, help me build it. Gather the materials I need.
Well, if all you need is some materials, sure. Why not? Just leave it to us.
Wonderful. Thank you. I believe I left a map in my storage shed that you can use to find what I... Grab that before you head out, and you shouldn't have any trouble.
Days?
If it ain't the present, it's the past, son. Must be the map Izo was talking about. Don't know what else it'd be. Well, let's see where it takes us. You ready?
Well, this is
a on now.
Let's do this. No time to waste. Is this the place we're looking for?
Shaky.
Keep it together.
My turn.
You're done.
Pretty rough on you, I know, but you've always come through for me. Thanks, buddy. Don't know where I'd be without you.
More to find.
Hold up. Is that everything? It is. Let's head back and check in with Izo.
Did you find everything? Excellent. It's all here. Thanks. If you're not in a rush, wait here while I finish up.
I get that it's your profession, but do you actually enjoy this, making weapons?
Of course I enjoy it. That's why I chose this job. Besides, it's the wielder who dictates the true value of a tool. Weapons, too. That's especially true for weapons. Yes, yes! I've done it! Feast your eyes on my masterpiece! My gift to you, I insist!
I may not be the gentlest owner, you know.
Use her as you like. The wielder dictates the value of the tool, remember? And by association, the value of the maker. Therefore, what good I put out into the world depends on who I entrust with my weapons. That's how I choose to see my part in it all.
Hell of a lot of pressure to put on some guy you just met, don't you think?
The adapter that your friend made. It's a gift in more ways than you know. He was thinking of your future, of what you might do after the dust settles. Today, you may have no choice but to wield a weapon. But tomorrow? Years from now? Think about it if you haven't. The man who fashioned your adapter is an inspiration in his own right. And that's no lie.
Stay a little too good.
Maybe one day you'll ask me to turn your arm into a giant egg beater. I'll make it so you can whip up a cake to serve 100.
Weird time to be joking around, man.
Not joking in the least. That's the price for my masterpiece. You owe me a cake fit for a king. So don't you go dying on me. You hear?
Yeah. Talk about a weirdo.
Friendly, though.
True. A weirdo with a heart of gold.
Friendly weirdo.
Okay, then.
You're up, man. Let's go. You're up.
I got you.
You're up, not bad.
But that ability is just so fucking OP, it's crazy.
According to folklore, this fantastical being is the tutelary of the forest. Thus, when disaster struck the Mako reactor, many believed it the result of Kujata's bestial wrath.
This looks fucking amazing. Holy fuck, like, straight up like the old Tomb Raider. What the fuck? Okay. Well, okay. Well, this is good. Why not? How far is this?
Too bad.
Get him!
That'll do. With me! I got
Spring data, I was able to locate an old Republic transmitter chip. It appears to be in the past leading to the reactor. The terrain you will need to traverse is littered with scrap metal and other such debris. Please watch your step.
Be the area Torgan was talking about. Though we're gonna need a chocobo to search.
Oh, okay. So what's here before? Cool. So, let's go.
Behold, the Magunga mushroom. Note its mushroom-like qualities. Just gotta be very careful.
What? What hell do I do? Okay, cool. This for requires not only a green thumb but a delicate as test for which portion of the mushroom. Oh, I understand now.
Worm ought to be around here somewhere. Okay, back to the birds. Everything? I can handle this.
Texas, I don't understand how these things work, like...
Goes.
sensational picking, Mr. Merc.
One more to go. Let's use the chocobos to find the last mushroom.
Are you serious? What the hell behind me? Oh, there we go. What was about this one? What the fuck? Oh, for fuck's sakes.
Get him!
Whatever.
You're up.
Oh, yeah.
Do it, right.
That ain't.
You're up.
With me.
Whatever.
Now on it. Ready?
Come on.
Let's go.
Go the fuck yourself. All I understand is, like, don't attack them until they stop dodging. And then attack again. Okay.
The third and final. Let's not mess this up.
That should be it for the mushrooms. Yep, looks like we're done. Let's get this stuff to Sisne.
Notice the helm is stopped. Wonder what happened.
This is the G1 for a round of burning
free. What do you want from me? More heat? Got it?
Calling fire!
It's about to burn the whole place down.
Enjoy your new home in the trash can. Am I ever gonna get this right? We come bearing ingredients. Why don't you give it one more shot? I can pitch in too.
Well, since you guys went to the trouble. Okay, one more shot.
What the fuck is going on?
Huh. This might turn out okay.
Told you.
The fairs are always inviting me over for dinner. Thought I'd be nice and return the favor by making them poison, apparently. But as you can see, I'm a sore loser.
Cooking's never as easy as you think.
Got that right. Didn't need to learn back in Midgar. The company provided all our meals. Tasted like garbage, though. Don't know how I stomach the stuff.
That bad, huh? But what about the bombberry flavor?
Bombberry? What, like the military rations?
Yeah, those. Sorry, that's really not important. What is important is the soup. The soup! Time to taste test!
Well there, might want to let it cool.
Right. Oops. That's pretty good. You can really taste the Gengaga mushrooms. This flavor is incredible.
Great job.
Let's go. That's all the side quest. You know what, there's Gwent, let's play Gwent, then I'll stop the live, and then, I don't know if I'll continue for today, we'll see how it goes. If not today, then tomorrow, we're gonna go meet Seed, who's gonna drive us the airplane, yay. Is Seed the playable character? No, right. I hope not, Burr, because there's too many characters to learn.
You there?
And I'm not even a big fan of the two new ones.
Don't ask how I can tell, but you're into Queen's Blood, aren't you? Isn't that great, Oscar?
Let's play. I've already fought the dog, let's see. The dog was my hardest enemy. And the Chocobo. Be even harder.
Thank you.
Okay. I guess Chocobo is a bit fucking retarded or something. He's probably win anyways. Good job though, Chocobo, you play very well.
Whoa! This is the first time I've ever seen Oscar lose! Didn't expect that. He can make it a lot harder, believe it or not. He's gonna make his television debut soon. He'll be up against a dog that plays, and we have to make sure he wins. He'll pull it off.
I don't know, the dog's kinda annoying, bro. Good luck, Taco Bomb on your side. Just fuck that dog, bro.
A different tune now. Instead of belting out profanity, the guy is literally whistling while he works. Kinda makes you wonder what this ultimate weapon actually is.
Look at all these eggs! My hens have been so good.
Can I move, please? Thank you. Let's check the store.
Don't worry, no pressure. Take as long as you want.
Yep, we got a lot of stuff to upgrade. Cool.
See ya. If you need something else.
Very nice. Be good, be good. Alright, so let's go do that card. Let's do the Gwent game and then go into the airfield and finish chapter 9.
Come now, that's enough. Sorry for... sitting around...
Fucking love that card.
So is that how you can sit? That's why you should. If you ever tire yourself.
Let's go, let's go. Yo, where's that? Novaland. Yeah, we need to go and do this quest too. But how the fuck do we fast travel over there? I have no idea. We need to unlock this over here to go back. Like... No, anyways, we'll just continue on forward. Right, let's go on here and let's go. What the fuck? Can I fuck go down? Like, what the hell? Okay. Oh, for fuck's sake.
With me!
Coming!
Keep it up! You're up! Do it!
You ready?
Nice. Alright, let's go back here then. And let's not go that way.
Send up smoke and we'll be right with you, folks. Bronco Airlines. Seriously? Guess so.
So, find anything?
Yeah, we gotta send up smoke.
Like, with a fire?
Wait, you've never heard of smoke signals? Wow. What do they teach you in Midgar?
Enough.
Well, leave it to someone who knows more than just enough. This is taking too long, but I can speed things up. Come to me, airplane! Follow the smoke! Come to
Come
me,
to me airplane.
Airplane! Follow the smoke! The smoke. Look! Right on cue!
Well, I'll be dead!
Told you I'd speed things up! Over here!
Bravo, sir! Where to, folks?
Cosmo Canyon, please.
Doc, you talk? The hell kind of magic trick is this? Not that I ain't seen crazier shit on my travels. Now, how many of you need guys?
Okay. Yeah.
Too many. But the old girl likes a challenge. With hazard pay, I'd say this is fair. And since I don't have much else going on, I'll be here scratching my ass till y'all pony up. Much obliged. Hop on board and sit where I tell you. Gotta make sure my baby's balanced just so. Hold on tight now, you hear? Fall out, you're on your own. Cosmo.
Here we go!
Personal Canyon. What are you doing? No.
I'd hold still if I were you. We wouldn't want any complications.
No, Professor.
Since you're so committed, I'm going to give you a special treatment. One that will surely make you into a hero. Once, this
no.
would have taken years, but now it takes a mere 18 hours, all thanks to me and my singular genius. I stand at the forefront of science, my brilliance a guiding light. Of course, we pioneers must be ready to do what others are not. Though even I wouldn't dare attempt to improve upon perfection.
What? Oh, hello there. Okay.
As far as I could. Hope y'all don't mind walking, because now you're on your own.
What about the next time we need a lift?
Send up a signal. Just make sure I got room to land. Happy trails to you.
All right. Thanks, Seed.
The veil's this way.
Okay, cool. It's nice. Cool, now we can go back to the other places. Bahamut is in this. I might have to do all of them then. Nice. Where are we? Oh wow. I wasn't even there before. We zoomed out. Cool. Nice.
Shawnee, that you?
Who's Shawnee? One of your chocobos? Did they run away from home?
My apologies. I don't believe we've met. I'm Kamaria, the owner.
So, Shawnee's your bird?
Goodness, no. Shawnee's my daughter. She's a chocobo jockey. Or was, till she fell off her mount during a race. Since then, she's completely lost her nerve. Refuses to get back in the saddle.
I see.
Oh! Tell me, you kids any good at riding?
Yeah, we dabble.
Wonderful! In that case, how would you like to use my training course? I had everything built brand new just for Shawnee, but now it's going to waste. Someone ought to put it to good use, don't you think? And who better than you young go-getters?
I don't know.
Ever run a ring course? It's simple. You strap yourselves in and fly through a series of hoops. I reckon you won't find a course like mine anywhere else.
Whoa! That sounds amazing! You want to try it, right? Imagine how jealous everyone will be.
Sure.
But first, you'll need to catch yourselves a chocobo. One that isn't afraid of heights. A fine bird like Apony ought to do you, though. Go ahead and ride her over to the training course. Twisting paths and bewildering brushlands, she'll guide you through it all with ease.
What? There's a tower right here. Oh, okay. No monsters? Thanks, okay. That's refreshing. Yeah, she like 50 of them.
Look! That's gotta be Apony!
Okay, so he stays like that for a while, I guess. This is checkpoints, which is good. Come on, you stupid bird, change. Fucking rotate. How am I supposed to do this? Okay. get it. Oh, okay. Qualification. Nice. Good bird.
Good bird.
Yay.
Easy, girl. We got you. Sick on Chocoback.
Amazing, isn't it? It's like my Chocobo and I share one mind, one body, one soul. Or maybe my body just hates shimmer cars, trains, and boats. They ought to find a way to make the ride smoother for their stuff. Put R&D to work.
Think they got other priorities.
Gotta go back there. I could do that. Oh, we'll go back later.
So, I've been meaning to ask you something. You said old Sephiroth's come back from the dead, right? And that's a bad thing. So, what I want to know is, how'd he do it? And what's he after?
He wants to save the planet.
But, wouldn't that make him a good guy?
Where did this penguin come from? But this thing had to pick them. That's what I think.
Sorry, but I gotta.
You're up.
Ready.
Keep it up.
I got you now. Don't overdo it.
So it's my turn? You've got this.
Let's do this.
Go on.
You're done. Hurry now.
Cosmo Canyon, a sacred sanctuary where the planet's greatest minds gather.
It's beautiful. More than I ever imagined. Come on, let's pick up the pace. I can hear it calling my name.
Yeah, me too.
Damn, this place looks amazing.
Hey, guys! It's me! Come back! Nanaki? I can't believe it.
What the fuck?
It really is you.
Gonna find out with the voice.
We were so worried. Welcome home.
Whoa.
Now, why don't you go pay your respects to fellow Bugenhagen? Come on.
You can let them through. They're good people. I promise. After all, they're the reason I'm here.
What in the hell was that? Hey guys, it's me. Who?
He's such a softie.
Real quick, gotta check something. An airship dropped these on us this morning. Wanted posters of the terrorists who bombed those reactors. But I think we can say you had nothing to do with all that. Even if Nanaki hadn't vouched for you, it's obvious. Welcome to the Sanctum of Planetology, Cosmo Canyon.
Thanks for keeping watch over the veil.
My pleasure. Are you about to head out on patrol? Can you believe it? Nanaki's back.
Wow. You see that wanted poster?
Must be that way for a reason.
Gotta keep on our toes.
Know this to an author of. Oh,
hello. I love this fucking place already. Like, goddamn. Hasn't even been 2 seconds on here. Love how I said I was gonna stop the live like a while ago. Like, lol. Yeah, now we just keep whirling. Time to tell us what the fuck's going on, Nanaki.
I was born and raised here, in this canyon. I was to become a watcher of the veil like those before me. Until I was taken by Shinra.
But what's the voice? What's up with the voice?
Now that I'm home and have repaid my debt to you, I plan to serve my village once more. I appreciate all that you've done for me. Thank you.
We're really gonna miss you, Red.
Oh, don't say that. You're only making this harder. I mean, I wish we had more time, but this is my duty.
I suppose it was your duty to act the old man.
I wanted you to treat me as an equal, not a dog.
Nanaki! Is that you, my boy?
Coming!
So, Was that goodbye?
Nah, I'm sure we'll see him around the canyon. The real question is, why'd we come here? To learn the secrets of planetology. Come on!
Can't forget that materia!
As for me... that'll do. I'm gonna steal some shut-eye, if you don't mind.
Then, we can see the sights.
Our minds, our very souls, all these...
Devote yourself to our planet. Only then shall you know love and joy everlasting.
Learn generosity.
Feel the energy.
As a conduit for the very wisdom of the planet. Traveler, you've more than a passing interest in Queen's Blood, yet have thee at ease. It is only natural to hear. Queen's Blood is of the indeed, Egypt. Come. Do as your heart bids.
No, we'll play Gwent another time. Oh, there he is. Let's follow him.
Not so fast. You see, this is where we keep all our valuables.
Oh, these are the friends I was talking about.
Thank you for looking after Malmaki. My name is Bugenhagen. I teach planetology here in the canyon. One could say I know a thing or two about our world.
A thing or two? I doubt there's a thing or two you don't know about it.
Well, it might seem that way to a child like yourself.
I'm not a child anymore. I'm 48.
40 what?
Malmaki here has a long life ahead of him. In human terms, I would say he's about 15 or 16 years old.
That's more than old enough. I can protect our Vale and everyone in it. Which is more than I can say for my good-for-nothing father.
Speaking of the members of our little community, have you announced your return to one and all, Malmaki?
Not yet. Be right back.
But where are my manners? Please, come in and have a look around.
Thank you.
if we've anything to fear.
Have my devices piqued your curiosity? They are essential to my studies of the planet. Anarchy never had much exposure to the outside world. I can only hope his travels with you have served to enlighten him.
A warm welcome to you, friends of Anarchy.
That's a scale model of our planet and the surrounding stars. One could say the dust it's collected represents the people who live upon it.
Oh my god.
Do you recognize that little scamp? I'll have you know that in his childhood, Nanaki was quite a handful. Generator. It harnesses the power of the wind to produce new airflows of its own. Perhaps you've encountered them before during your travels. Telescope on the planet. With it, you can see to the edge of the galaxy. There's no better view of the stars than through this scope. But the lens could do with some cleaning. My apologies.
The lights we observe here.
That again, huh? Indeed, one I've heard all too often of late. This tubing allows us on the surface to hear the inner voice of the planet.
What we just heard didn't come from the planet, though. That was definitely the voice of a weapon.
You seem awfully sure of yourself, miss.
Because we saw them, with our own eyes. Two, in the Corel and Gungaga reactors. They were loud. And huge.
A fascinating account, were it true. However, such grand delusions could be a sign of Mako poisoning. Do see a doctor.
Excuse me?
Okay.
Yes. That would do them some good. Judging from everything you've said, the three of you are unfamiliar with basic planetology. But it is never too late to learn. Please, come with me. I present to you our planetarium. While the Shinra building features the latest iteration, this particular one is my original design. Now then, without further ado...
CG? CG? That just looks fucking gorgeous, man. God damn.
Wow.
This is only the beginning.
A shooting star.
Planetology is not simply the study of the cosmos and the celestial bodies that dwell in it. Rather, it is a quest to comprehend the cyclical nature of life. Behold, the planet we call home. It was from its soil, so teeming with life, that mankind was born. And like all living things, man is fated to die. So, what happens next? The body withers and returns to the planet. But what of the mind, the spirit, the soul? Much like its former vessel, it too returns whence it came. The great river where all intertwine and circle the planet without end. A cycle of continuous convergence and divergence. The ceaseless ebb and flow that is the life stream. An apt name, though it is as much a reservoir as it is a stream, being the sum of the planet's spiritual energy. It is the very essence of our star. The blood coursing through its planetary veins. And if ever that essence were to be entirely depleted, basic principles of planetology.
So you're saying that Mako is spiritual energy, which we're using up?
Just so. Siphoned from the planet and processed for industry, that energy can no longer fulfill its true purpose. It is fated to fuel man's machinery, then fade away.
Okay. But does it actually fade away? I mean, what if it doesn't? What if it just returns to the life stream in a different form? Is that possible?
A novel theory, suggestive of a lack of understanding. However, that can be overcome with time and education.
You rang?
Please escort this young lady to our seminar room, would you?
Right this way. Okay. Hey, can I come?
Got a question. Planet runs out of energy. It and everything on it dies, right?
Yes.
There any way to avoid this? Like, making the spiritual energy stronger?
Why are you asking me such things? I'm sorry. I've come to realize that I'm somewhat stuck in the past. We've entered an era in which humanity exerts unprecedented influence over its environs. And as both the planet and society evolve, so too must science. And yet it seems that I cannot. Perhaps I'm much too old of a dog to learn any new tricks. Was my explanation of planetology not to your liking? Perhaps a seminar would provide a more agreeable experience.
Okay. Crazy old man.
For taking such great care of Nanaki for us. Fellow Bugenhagen instructed me to let you take anything you think might prove useful on your journey. Check out the storeroom when you have a chance.
Right this way.
Never forsake us.
This village is lame. Did you know none of the materia here is even real? And don't get me started on the planetologists. Bunch of blowhards in love with the sound of their own voice.
If people everywhere resolve to not take her bounty for granted, and offer her
one must exercise patience. Fancy running into you.
The canyons also. I made sure to bring. Just let me know if you find any good photo spots.
Tell me.
I heard from fellow Bugenhagen. By all means, please come and join the seminar. Follow me if you would.
Which would you say is a more worthy pursuit?
They are both one and the same. Wouldn't you agree?
I ask you this. Who among you has looked inward?
Always been on the bigger side, but I've never been into physical stuff. Painting and poetry are more my thing. My old man, he used to say it was a waste.
You guys are enjoying the songs.
What about you, miss? You must have a story to share. Please.
Me? Okay. Where to begin? I fell into the life stream. I don't have words to describe it, except beautiful, maybe? It was a lot to take in. Feelings of kindness washed over me. Long forgotten memories came flooding back. It was a warm, comforting place. But there was also conflict. A war between the planet and its enemies. And we can't let them win. We need the planet, and it needs us. We have to rise up, fight back, defend it from this terrible threat. Thing is, I don't know how to do any of that. And I hoped you might have the answer. I'm not criticizing planetology or anything, and I'm not trying to scare anybody either. I just... you know... never mind. This is all coming out wrong.
Please. Do not be discouraged. Should you ever wish to try again, we would be more than happy to listen. What matters is that you keep challenging your beliefs. Stop doing that, and the answers will forever elude you. On that note, I think we should adjourn for the evening. The River of Lights is almost upon us, so let us head to the torch.
See you at the festival.
Festival. It's another date. I was gonna get ruined by someone or something, like always. Because we can have nice things. Why are we looking at the screen? Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. Wow, looks nice.
Look at them, gathered around the fire. Just like us that day. Me, and Mom, and Dad. If only we could do that again. Never mind. Just forget I said anything.
I'll lend an ear.
Whenever I think about my mom, my chest swells with so much pride, I feel like it'll burst. But When it comes to my dad, I just... Sorry, I can't. Still not ready. Sorry, I can't. Still not ready.
I had the pleasure of talking to a mentor. Said it was presumptuous of me to think I could save the planet. She decides her own fate, you see. As rain cleanses the skies, so too does she cleanse herself of filth. So what? We sit here and theorize while the planet rinses and repeats?
No, we fight, or nothing will change.
That's what I said. I knew you'd see it my way, Merc. Thanks.
Did I sound as awkward as I felt?
You did good. Can't help it if they suck at listening. I got what you were saying.
I kinda wanted everyone to get it, though.
To hell with everyone.
Great advice. Thanks.
Put your faith in our great mother. She would never forsake us. Never abandon us.
When you die, you return to the planet? That has literally got to be the dumbest thing I have ever heard. Once you die, that's that.
Why do you think that?
I just do. I believe in anything else until I see some actual proof.
Man, I can't wait to see...
Some saber like grains of sand on the beach of the universe. Fatalist idiots. Spend my whole life trying to prove I'm wrong, but sitting here, looking up at the sky, you kind of help feeling pretty minuscule.
Man, I can't wait to see what you've got planned. But it's more.
So, I'm an ancient, as in a steward of the planet, one of those ancients, or to be more precise, the only ancient. For the most part, it's been a source of pain. I've been held against my will, I've been watched, I've been ignored, even hated. And it's been that way ever since I was little. My blood's been nothing but a curse. If I ever started to forget, something would remind me of what I was and bring me crashing back down to Earth. It was always the same. Time after time. I'd be shown a glimmer of hope, only to have it snatched away. I was never gonna be normal. That much was clear. So my blood's been a curse, but it's also been a blessing. It's brought some wonderful people into my life, friends that I love. And for once, I think I'm okay. Happy even. And all that pain feels worth it. Even if I can't lead a normal life, there is one thing I can do. Return their kindness. And try to make the most of what I've been given.
There! It is time!
Whoa!
Pretty sappy, huh?
So, this is where you've been, Nanaki.
What's up?
There's something of great import I need to show you. And by that, I mean all of you. Join me, would you?
Diggly, all of us, huh? Okay.
What did you all think of the River of Lights?
So much for sharing.
For whatever reason, the ceremony has drawn a number of tourists to the Vale as of late. When I ask for their impressions, they often speak of how beautiful it was. Some claim they were even moved to tears. It's an overwhelmingly positive reception, I'm happy to say. To stir the human soul is no small feat, and it pleases me to know that the River of Lights possesses such power. Alas, my hopes to parlay their emotional response into a deeper intellectual curiosity. They have yet to be fulfilled. People are surrounded by cats, dogs, birds, and trees. They know that life is all around them, be it through the birth of a baby or the blooming of a flower. They bear constant witness to the blessed cycle of creation. Yet they've no interest in the welfare of our planet. Forgive me for sharing my idle thoughts. Keeping them to myself is quite a challenge in my old age.
Get down. You hear?
I'm glad to know that Aerith has plans like you to keep her company. Today's experience was surely the wheel of the planet. Cheers.
Well then, shall we proceed?
But I thought this door was
sealed so that none may enter? Why, yes. And by my own hand, no less. However, you've a trial to undertake.
I do?
If you wish to prove yourself and become a Watcher of the Veil, that is. I presume you are prepared.
Yeah.
I will also require your assistance in carrying out the trial. Much danger awaits within, and I wish to ensure his safety. When you're ready, simply say the word.
Alright, we shall stop here before we go to the trial. And we shall continue tomorrow. I've done quite a lot today, I'd say. Damn. Nice. I'm loving this. Also, that cloud smile was awkward as fuck. But Aerith seemed to like it, so... yes, worth it. Alright, y'all. See you on the next episode.